Thank you, sir. In my efforts not to cry, that didn't help, so thank you. Sir, thank you for doing that. You know, over the years, we've agreed to disagree, but I want you to know that it has been an honor to serve under you, and I appreciate you being here to do this for me. Welcome, Lieutenant Colonel Butt, Major Cortez, Marines and sailors, friends and family. You know, I know why everybody gets up here and cries when they do this, because you don't sleep the night before. You don't get to sleep, and your brain's overrun with all kinds of emotions. So I'm going to try to keep this short, but I want to recognize a few people first. Staff Sergeant Wunderlich stepping in today to be part of this ceremony. I know it's your birthday, so happy birthday. You've been a great friend. Thank you so much. Jeff, for the invocation and the prayers, thank you. It means a lot to have you do it here for me today, and I really appreciate it. To the 3rd Marine Aircraft Wing Band, you guys sound fantastic as usual. Thank you for being here. Gunner Sergeant Parrott, you don't get enough credit for what you do, brother. You're putting together 3 or 4 ceremonies a week, and I know it's not easy. I know your retirement is coming up soon as well, so good luck to you, and thank you. To the Marines in formation here today, I know this is not what you thought you'd be doing when you signed up for the Marine Corps, but like I used to tell my Marines, whether you serve 4 years or 30 years, your contribution to this country and to society in general is more than most people do in their whole lives, so be proud of that. And know that your contribution to me here today is not taken for granted. I appreciate it. Thank you. Joined the Marine Corps 20 years ago, and as I look back and reflect on it, I can honestly say that I am proud and satisfied with everything that I have accomplished. But I know that I couldn't have accomplished these things without the camaraderie of the Marines, the support of my friends and family. And so I want to take some time to speak directly to my family. My mother-in-law, Lucy, thank you for being here. When I was just a young chump in high school and I showed up on your door knocking, looking to date your daughter, you welcomed me in with open arms and you showed me love and you made me a part of your family from the beginning. And I love you for it. Thank you very much. To my mom and dad, this is when it gets tough. To my mom and dad, to my dad, Army Vietnam vet, you were the first hero I ever knew. And you were gone a lot, and I know that made it hard, but when you were home, when you were there, you did your best to try to raise me right. And I know it didn't seem like I was always listening, but I was, and I'm only the man I am today because of you. So thank you, and I love you. To my mom, you've always been there for me. You've always taken care of me. I can never forget that because every time I talk to you, you remind me of it. Time was. But you have always been there for me. You've been more than a mother. You've been a friend. When I need someone to talk to, you're always there to listen. But most importantly, you've taught me the importance of family. And I thank you for that, and I love you. To my kids, Andrew. At 11 years old, you are already one of the finest people I've ever met. You have so much compassion in you. You have a heart of gold. Don't ever lose it. I'm very proud of you and I love you. To my daughter, Ashley. At 6 years old, you already have so much personality. I don't know if I can handle much more of it. You're a beautiful young lady, and I know that you're going to grow up to be a strong, independent woman. And you'll be able to accomplish anything you set your heart and mind to. I'm proud of you, sweetie, and I love you. Angela. Well, I mean, what is there to say? 20 years in the Marine Corps has been easy, right? It hasn't always been easy. We've had some very hard times to deal with. Deployments to Afghanistan, deployments to Okinawa, new deployments, Jacksonville, North Carolina. No, Jacksonville wasn't that bad. But you know, it has been hard. And the only reason we made it through any of that is because you are a rock. You are the strongest woman I know. People ask us, how did we manage to stay together all these years, even living this Marine Corps life? And, you know, there's all the cliche answers, honesty, dedication, lots of drinking. But the answer is quite simply true love. You are my true love, and I love you so much. Thank you. So I made it this far without crying, so I think I'm gonna quit while I'm ahead. But every single one of you that's here, I wish I could take the time to thank each and every one of you. Aunts, cousins, friends, family, just neighbors, all of you. You've all had an influence on my life, and I will never forget it. So please, at the end of the ceremony, join me for a reception over at the Staff and CEO Club. I just want to thank you all very much, and Semper Fi.